Good evening, everyone.
Hi, hi Rupesh.
Hi Rupesh, good evening.
Good evening, and I believe all the attendees are right now muted and hence they cannot speak, but I think we are good to start now. So good evening everyone once again, and welcome to today's CEDIA Orientation webinar. I am Rupesh Shah, Regional Development Consultant based out of Mumbai, India. So before we started, or before we get started, I just want to inform you guys about certain things, that if you have any login or technical issues, please let us know by using the question box located in the navigation panel on your right. And we are recording today's session, and the link to the recorded webinar and any other resources will be sent via email. A recorded version will also be on the CEDIA YouTube channel. So as I informed earlier, right now we have all lines on mute to avoid any kind of background noise and disturbance. Right? All right. So let's move on. So here's a little introduction of all of us right now who are going to be on the webinar, especially going to be taking it. So that's me on the left, and you have Anand and Manoj in the subsequent pictures. So this webinar will share an overview of CEDIA member benefits and instructions to access your benefits. So whether you have joined to build your professional network, save money on training, or keep current with technology, you are right where you belong. So we'll also be taking a look at some of the initiatives of CEDIA, right? And you know, what kind of work are we doing to raise the profile and standard of the industry? I hope that knowledge would be useful in the coming 1 hour. And let me tell you also a little about how CEDIA is built. CEDIA is built on volunteers who support us with creating content, making standards, teaching, and many more things. Today I'm joined by two CEDIA members. You're seeing them on your screen, the pictures of course. And they are the two CEDIA members who volunteered to be on this call with me today. So before I move forward, I would like to have an intro done, you know, by both of them. So Manoj, I would start with you maybe. Would you like to introduce yourself to our listeners?
Okay, good evening CEDIA India family. I am Manoj Soni. I own a company called AV4U, and we are a CEDIA member since 2014. We help architects and clients for creating world's finest home theaters and customized audio video solutions from design to the completion and calibration. At present, we are a CEDIA India core group member, CEDIA accredited presenter, outreach instructor, and AVIXA India advisory members. We have a team of THX HN, CATS certified AV professional who help us in doing the right job for our clients. We regularly use Cinema Designer, which is a very good tool from CEDIA. And we use a lot of white papers of CEDIA, which is provided by CEDIA, which is accessible to us, all of us as a CEDIA member. I am here to make you aware about the various activity done by CEDIA for us as a members. Thank you.
Hi guys, Anand here from AV Excellence. I think I know quite a few of you guys, but you know, it's just best to keep networking more and more, and we make more friends and you know, along the way. I've been a CEDIA member for almost 12 years now. I've been one of the founder members for CEDIA in India, and I caught on a little early in the day to and realize the potential of being a member with CEDIA, that I felt that I could extract the benefits, and I've seen the kind of benefits that they've been extending over a period of time, a little by little, and always adding value into the equation. The only question comes as to how we can harness it the best way, and that's what this session is all about. Any of you guys are coming down to Pune sometime, drop in, connect with me, and it'll be great. Rupesh, back to you. We can start this.
Okay, cool. Thank you to both of you. Let's move on. All right. So I am sure that we do have some individuals on today's call who are new to CEDIA, or maybe it's fair to say that, you know, not entirely new, but, you know, are not completely aware of what we do. So I would like to just talk a little about that first. And to start with, CEDIA, yes, is a leading global authority that represents over 3,700 members worldwide. And as I'm talking about this, last year, we celebrated our 30th birthday. So in India, we currently have a growing community with 44 members. Yeah. And but yeah, this is a little 2 month old data. As we talk today, we would be easily crossing about 50 plus. And thanks to the industry for supporting us and my work. So CEDIA has a presence in India since 2013. We've brought training classes, networking events to Mumbai, Delhi, and Bangalore. That's our history. And of course, going forward, we would like to increase it and make it more consistent across the country. Yeah. Next slide, please. Okay. So what I want to talk about on this slide is, of course, what do we do? We do all these things that you're seeing, but I would like to address a lot with respect to India, because that's more relevant. So let me share with you some of the key initiatives that were taken up by me since the time I took over this role of a consultant with CEDIA. And even before I proceed further, I would like to thank the industry for supporting me and providing me with a lot of feedback with respect to the following. A, how our industry is organized in India. B, how are the businesses running. C, the pain points of integrators and distributors. And yes, based on the insights I got, I tried analyzing the possible gaps where CEDIA can help filling up with relevant initiatives and help the industry grow and prosper. So to mention a little more in details, the first feedback that I received, and I think everyone still agrees that this is relevant, was on the training aspect, its consistency, and also on the level of trainings that are needed by the industry. So what we understood from that feedback is that there is a clear need for training in the industry, right from basics up to intermediate as well as advanced. And in order to make these trainings more consistent and available across the country, we needed to build a pool of Indian SMEs who can deliver trainings on behalf of CEDIA. To achieve this, we conducted a CAP training. CAP basically stands for CEDIA Accredited Presenter. So that's the train the trainer training for the first batch of 8 volunteers who've supported us with this initiative to spread education to our Indian community. So again, special thanks to all our CAPs, to all the 8 volunteers, and especially our international trainer, Peter Eilert, who flew down to India to conduct this class. So what we did after this was we conducted a mix of basic as well as some advanced face-to-face trainings in 2019 in Mumbai and in Bangalore. It touched the basic aspects of networking, audio, video, control, and lighting, and also touched upon some advanced trainings on home theaters relevant to project management for high-performance cinemas, lighting design for cinema designers, and practical acoustic class. So this was the initiation that we took in, you know, after we received the feedback. The second feedback was on creating more visibility and awareness of CEDIA to our industry and also to the design and build community. And I'm sure a lot of you would agree that the design and build community is very relevant as a lot of our pipeline gets generated from that community. So what we did is increase awareness to our own industry. We participated in both the editions of Smart Home Expo. That was the first of its kind that was done in India by someone. And it happened both in Mumbai and Bangalore, respectively, to interact with the industry, give them necessary inputs on education, certification, and how they can utilize CEDIA's platform to build their business. In the same conference, we also conducted a CEDIA, a CPD, you know. We'll talk more about it later, but just for your information, we conducted a CPD on connected homes in Mumbai to create awareness of CEDIA and its members to the design and build community. And of course, followed by a presentation on membership that powers success to explain the benefits of being a CEDIA member. So third feedback was more of a regular need for the industry to meet often and network, and also present an opportunity for the manufacturers and the distributors to come in front of the industry and educate them about the latest trends and the technology updates. Following or taking or rather paying heed to it, we conducted our biggest ever tech summit in August 19 in Mumbai, which saw very good reception by the industry, both from the integrators and the trade suppliers side. It was attended by over 120 participants across 68 companies. So some further initiatives in pipeline is completing a formal tie-up with the IIID, conduct our CPDs across the major chapters in India, participate in the key events, and secure speaking slots to create awareness of our industry and the professional work that we do. Not only this, we also want to create some networking events for the IIID chapters by taking support of our distributor members and thereby creating a visibility of CEDIA and all its members amongst other industry associations. I'm also in touch with some other associations like BICSI, TAIT, that's called TATE, and AES and ISLE, and many more. And that's the plan, you know, to create a lot of awareness across different associations so that we can all grow together and, you know, have a lot of best practices from other associations also to us. So that's very new and is already started. Thanks to our AVIXA counterpart, Gaurav Majumdar, whom a lot of you would be knowing. We could all meet together 2 weeks back across all the different associations. So that's a little update about what we did from India perspective, but quickly running through what do we do. We do all these things. You know, we provide industry specific training, we create resources, we run events worldwide, we raise industry awareness in this way, and we do a lot of research. We recognize industry achievements. All this is going to be discussed more in details in the coming slides. So let's move on further. Jen, can we have the next slide, please? All right. So before I move forward, just want to introduce you to what we do majorly. That's of course trainings. That's a key part of all our activities. So the industry looks to CEDIA for training, both on the business side as well as the technical side. We do have a lot of training programs around both of these aspects. And that's where the industry experts and the staff keep training, keep themselves updated and available. Okay. So CEDIA offers a variety of ways for you to get the training that you need, be it online or be it in person. So let's take a look at some of the training resources available to you. And to do this, I would, you know, request Anand to take you through some few slides where he will share, you know, what is available for a member from a CEDIA platform perspective. So Anand, over to you.
Thanks, Rupesh. I don't see any interaction as such from everybody who's attending, so they can, you know, add in questions and, you know, put some questions up over there if they, you know, if anybody wants, you know, just so that there is some amount of interaction as well. So feel free to do that as and when you feel the need, and we will address that also. So coming to this aspect of CEDIA, which is something that I really like, is the online training options that are available on the CEDIA site itself. I don't know how many members and non-members are attending, but we tend to use these quite effectively, but quite a few members are still unaware of these sessions. So, you know, there are options available to fit all your, you know, your time and budget restrictions. Of course, in today's time, it's quite relevant that it's online, it's perfect. You can sit in the comfort of your office you know, everybody's confined to their own locations. So it's easy to, you know, take some time out, figure out what options are available. You know, the first being the lessons. These are digestible bites of training, each under 10 minutes. They're free. They're exclusive to CEDIA members. It includes, the topics include, you know, basic video calibration, digital audio signals, and stuff that even if you as the business owner know, you know, the basics, but it always helps orient your staff in your office, and it helps them, you know, get a bit little better oriented and being a little technically prepared. You know, secondly, they've got e-courses. These are self-paced interactive courses. They include videos, interactive activities supported by a participant guide. You can all take advantage of a range of topics, you know, including home theater room design, IP for technicians. You know, there are a few options available. And, you know, as you discover, it's quite interesting, the kind of valuable material that's available to the members. Once you're online, you can also check out, you know, the live and recorded webinars. Like today's webinar, members are free to access, but CEDIA has such a range of content, including emerging trends and best business practices. I remember that, you know, there was something about HDR that CEDIA had a webinar, which was about 3 years back, maybe, you know, so that puts us in a serious advantage over our competitors and with our customers to, you know, have a value add over the others, you know, being a member. Very soon, CEDIA will be launching a new, you know, additional training options, which will give you easier access to training whenever you need it, you know. Wendy, would you like to add to this?
Yes, you're absolutely correct. CEDIA is launching a new learning management system, which is a new platform for online education. There is a number of new training courses being developed at the moment, and we hope to have some further news about this in the next 2 weeks.
Wow, nice. And, you know, my can we have the next slide on this?
And just to complement what Anand is saying, as we are changing over the slide, Anand, I would also like to add up to this that what we just listed on the earlier slide were just examples of the courses available online, you know, those short lessons or e-courses. You actually go and drop down and drag down, you'll see a lot of more options there as well. So it's not only limited to those. So yeah, it's a brilliant resource there.
Yeah, so continuing on with that, I mean, today, you know, all this training actually comes in use, and it is critical. It is critical to lead, you know, us as business owners and our staff who can become CEDIA certified. You know, you don't have to travel. CEDIA has partnered with Criterion. It's a global testing center. So, you know, from the comfort of your business environment or even home, you know, you can take your CEDIA certification in your local area. You know, it just brings in a lot of value for us as a member. You know, with this, you know, if you have a look at the link that is shown above, of course, it's for the members, but, you know, in this fast-paced home technology industry, there's always more to learn. We have to keep learning constantly and keep evolving our business along with the technology that keeps changing. You know, luckily for us, CEDIA has brought together some of the industry's brightest minds to be able to develop a bank of resource that you can turn to for learning, reference, best practices, and more. These resources focus on industry-specific knowledge and information in both business and technical disciplines. I've used some of these resources. It's quite nice. I can only say that if you haven't seen the value, is what we're trying to bring this attention to. Everyone, that you can use this to your advantage. The membership is completely worth it. If you have a look at the white papers that CEDIA has, it gives us a close look at the business and technical approaches to various topics in the home technology industry. They've got wireless audio, telepresence, how mobile devices are also changing the scenario for us, and these white papers are absolutely free for CEDIA members. Some of the recent white papers that were launched, which I remember downloading, was AV over IP systems and quality of the power supply, and how it makes a difference. I think Rupesh can give a little bit more insight now as to the education aspect. Rupesh?
Sure. Thanks, Anand. Thanks for providing your insights and your way of looking at how these things have helped you. Before I move on, I would just like to add a little. I like to share this because this is all experience which I'm getting on field. So there was one such case where a member was actually looking at some kind of authentic information to decide at what height or what should be the right height for a television to be placed on a wall. Very basic, of course, we all understand that, but he wanted something which is like authentic, someone's backing it. And he was trying to search a lot online, and he happened to just post a message. He's a member, of course, and he just happened to post a message and asking for help. And what I did was I was actually traveling, and I just logged in to the portal. I just searched for a relevant white paper and I forwarded it to him. And to his joy and excitement, it was like, where was this? I was trying to search this on Google from last 24 hours, and you've actually helped us getting this because my team is very grateful to you for it. So what I realized was that we have a lot of information lying there. It may be a little old, maybe a year back or two, but at the end, the basics still remain the same, right? A lot of things do not need any updates or upgrades. So that's what I want to convey, that what Anand was talking about white papers, we've got loads of information there. So please do access for members, and as well as for non-members, if you want to download, it's there for you to do that. So I want to talk a little more about trainings for 2020, because that's what we were planning to do based on the feedback that we received. And we are actually in the process of making a training calendar for the year with more trainings. And with the current situation that we all are facing, hopefully with the COVID-19 subsiding soon, that's what we hope to, we should be able to offer 6 to 7 different training opportunities to the Indian community. Again, it may be more, it may be less, depending on what the situation is. So I'm really not in a position to actually come out with a calendar because of the restrictions now that we've come in, or rather has been imposed on us. So, but I can definitely give you some insights that training would be a mix of boot camps, half-day trainings, some two-day trainings, more or less hosted at some member premises. So that it's very convenient and we do not have to end up renting up expensive premises. So that's the whole idea of doing all these trainings somewhere in house, where a member is ready to let us use the space so that we can bring the overall cost of the trainings down. And in addition to this, as Anand shared earlier about the launch of our LMS, and I think Wendy spoke about it, we may be able to help our Indian community take a new higher training track. What is that? It is basically meant for any new hire that you take in your company, you know, or anyone who's just starting to or thinking to start off their career in the residential sector or residential segment, for them, this new hire training rack will be very useful because it will clear a lot of the basic concepts, right? So we are going to launch that soon, and I'll keep the industry posted about how are we doing that. So it will be a mix of the new hire training track, which will go online, and of course, some face-to-face class for the practicals, you know, wherever it is relevant. For example, if it's a boot camp, you will need to have some kind of practical exposure as well. So it'll be a mix of that. We'll be seeing how do we arrange that, right? Apart from this, we are also in process of providing our distributor members technical trainings as per their needs, okay? To train their teams using our Indian SMEs. This is now a benefit offered to our distributor members only as an additional advantage, because that's why we are creating a value for all kinds of membership, be it an HTP, which most of you are, that's a home technology professional. We also have a set of members called as distributor members who also look for additional value adds that we can give to them. So based on that feedback, we've done this, and for the distributors, we are also in the process of designing or rather giving them certain options which are relevant to their company so that they can train their teams and then in turn give better services to their dealer network. So that is also under process and under discussion. So before I move forward, do we have any questions, Jen? I mean, because I'm not able to see any questions. So if there is a question, then I can,
hi,
we can
absolutely
address.
Yes. So someone has asked, well, there's a comment and I'll just read it out if you'd like to talk on it. Most architects do not care about standards and are hard to convince. Also, the role of acoustics earns very little respect. How does CEDIA certified professional for a company help generate more leads? So I think the question is, how does membership help with raising someone's platform and therefore generating more leads for them as a company?
All right, a very good question, and I think this was a part of, you know, what we had to cover also in the upcoming slides. So I would like to, you know, wait till then, and maybe if Anand or Manoj would like to contribute before that, I'm more than happy for their comments on this.
I can answer this. Rupesh, this, you know, architects start caring the moment they start taking you seriously, and they start taking you seriously when the kind of solutions and the knowledge that you have is more than what they have. The moment they start realizing the value in your solutions and in the way you handle a situation, no single home theater site is standard. There is no such thing as a standard home cinema room or a standard solution that one size fits all. Every room has its own technical challenges. When you come up with the right kind of ideas based on the kind of knowledge that you have got. So again, coming back to the knowledge that is being imparted by the leaders in the industry through CEDIA is the value add that you bring, to be able to use in real world applications. The moment you start counter asking certain questions that if you do this, then what will happen? So this is going to be an issue. And when you start highlighting those complications to the designer, to the architects and interior designers, they look at your valid points and start taking you a lot more seriously. The moment they take you seriously, that's when you know you've got their respect and you got their business as well. They don't want to go one step forward without consulting you for any of their future projects. Yes, you will always have some exceptions who think they know a lot more or whatever, but then it becomes, you know, easy to handle those situations when you are sure of your own solutions and you have somebody to, you know, discuss these certain site issues, certain difficult situations that you face at site. Like Rupesh just mentioned, these events that happen, trainings that happen across. One part is the training. On the other side, when we as industry professionals all meet each other, these questions can get discussed at those events. And I'm sure somebody or the other in the group always comes out with a nice solution that we can adapt to and make it interesting for, making it easier for us to, tackle future situations. Back to you, Rupesh.
Okay, thanks. And I'll definitely. Oh, yeah, please.
Rupesh, I would like to add something on the, Anand said. When we are having a CEDIA certified people in our team, the designer fraternity is always, start believing that, we are bringing a value to on the table by giving a lot of important inputs in terms of the consideration in design. So gradually they start taking us very seriously. They give us the due respect, and it is I'm sure that it is a edge over the other competitors who are not CEDIA certified. We are always putting a value on the table.
Okay, thanks Manoj and Anand for your insights. I'll also be addressing this as we go further. Different avenues where you can actually use this platform to generate more business for you indirectly, So moving forward, let's talk about some events for 2020. So we look forward to participating in some industry events. Of course, we've been right now participating in events like Smart Home Expo that we did earlier in May and in December last year. And other similar events, whichever where we find, more relevant participation. Just for your information, we got to know on the weekend that the Smart Home Expo, people who attend it or rather, visit the show, they have also kind of postponed it for this time on account of the coronavirus situation. So just that little bit of information for you. Other than this, we'll be having a tech summit, maybe this time in a bigger format of 2 days. With industry training and education both, wherein the idea is to also have a lot of visibility given to the brands. And of course, as you as industry, whoever is going to participate, you'll also get a lot of face-to-face interaction with all these manufacturers or distributors and can have a lot of, networking happening. So the details are yet to be finalized. Again, unfortunately, because of the situation, we're not able to take a call. What do we do and when do we do it? But yeah, the tentative plan is in mind, and we'll be keeping you posted about it. Other than this, we are also looking to participate in some relevant design and build events. Maybe this also is a part of the answer to the question asked, how are we going to become more relevant and how do we sit? How do we face the DNB guys? So the design and build events are going to be the place where we will be showcasing, what CEDIA professional community is all about, in terms of those small snippets of education that we give to them. Triple ID is another thing that I'm going to be focusing on. So maybe a Triple ID national event is where we go and create more awareness of CEDIA and the professional community. So in this way, we plan to also increase our visibility amongst them, and that's where the respect also starts coming in. So over to Anand and Manoj, both for a very short comment on yours. Why do you think is it so important for others to support these kind of face-to-face events, that we organize? What do you think? What's the relevance?
Well, like I just mentioned a few minutes back that, when we network and when we meet up with other partners across the country, it brings in, Rupesh, so much of value add and knowledge and insight as to, some of the technical challenges we face, some of the commercial challenges we face, some of the, competitive challenges that we face, besides just the regular learning curve. So you know, always when you meet with other people in the industry, you understand and, you know, you get to network and you get to understand, you know, their workarounds and their solutions to those. And sometimes those solutions are quite simple. Only question comes that, you know, if, you know, that we tend to forget some of them. So I think Manoj would also be able to give some insight as to when we network, there's so much value add that happens that I try not to miss any of these events.
Sure, Anand. And when we meet, no, we share some good practices, some best practices which we do individually, and no, would like to share with the community, and it always helps no, all of us to grow in the business, be it the commercial side, the technical side, or the challenges which we face. When we meet and discuss, it is always good for all of us to now grow in the business.
Thanks both of you for your comments on this. Moving on further, so yes, this is another area that I would like to talk about. How do you showcase your business? And I think this is completely relevant to every integrator that I meet when I'm on field and I go and interact and you know, talk to them. And this is what comes in as a latent need, you know, that how do I use my you know, CEDIA platform to gain more mileage out of it. So I want to talk a little more about that, right? The next slide. So yes, leveraging on this global connection is something which I want to focus on. First, you may have noticed that yes, CEDIA has a few websites, right? So we have a website called as, of course, www.cedia.net. There is a website called cedia.org and some more websites. So yes, there are a lot of websites to access, but as mentioned earlier, we are so excited to share that we'll be launching a new global website. And what this new global website will do is it will create one central location for every designer, installer, manufacturer, as well as the end customer, with improved access to resources for our members, a consolidated hub for worldwide education and training opportunities, right? And streamlined navigation, the future of home technology is gonna get even closer no matter where you are. So some of the brilliant resources that you can use to showcase your business is something which we give to every member. Every HTP, it's a search tool we call the Finder service. So a lot of you are members on this call would already be aware that your profiles get listed on the CEDIA portal, so that, you know, anyone wants to do a check as to whether you're a CEDIA member or not, they can easily go and check. And that's where you also showcase yourself that you're a CEDIA member. So any of your staff who's also certified is also shown up on that, you know, that a CEDIA certified professional on staff. So this Finder service, it allows all the home technology professionals to be connected by the interested clients. They can search anywhere in the world. So don't be surprised that someone who's out of India may want to, you know, look at integrators in India. You know, someone would want to buy a home here. And so these are the ways that you can get exposed with your good business profile. So while these changes are happening, I encourage you to make sure you've uploaded photos, company logo, and also completed your profile so that your company looks its best. So this is one. Talking about how to showcase yourself, I would want Manoj to actually, you know, add a lot of insights here on this slide.
Thank you, Rupesh. I will touch upon a few more activities CEDIA does for our members. The CEDIA Award program recognizes the top projects and the products in the industry. And there is no award for the innovation, the creativity, and the technical expertise which we display in our own projects. We are a part of EMEA region, and India is a part of EMEA region. We have a various region. So various awards for home cinemas, the best media room, and the documentation, and the best track. And no, in home cinema also, we have a various category. Let's say home cinema level 1, level 2, and level 3. Then we have awards on the best integration home. When we apply for the awards, we submit our project details. And that's the great opportunity to showcase our good work, which we do on the global platform. And if I talk about the previous year's awards, India has won the multiple awards for various categories in home cinema, the media room. If I talk about last year, one of the showroom was the finalist in the CEDIA Awards. So it is a matter of pride for all of us. We have something to show to the world that, yes, this is the good work which we are doing. And no, the entire community has recognized our good work. And now this is a time, you know, CEDIA Award is already open, and all of us can put our entries into that for any kind of help which is required. All the webinars are already there. You can talk to Rupesh, you can talk to any of us to know more how to put the projects, how to do the documentation, and we are always there to help you out. And to learn more, we have a website called cedia.net/awards. You can also download the CEDIA podcast episode from which is available, and which is called Demystified the CEDIA Award, and tips from judges and winners for the additional insight. Can you move to next slide, please? Yeah.
Just allow me to add in some few insights of mine when I was in UK last year.
Yeah.
I was privileged to be a part of the awards night, and what I learned in this whole process, and this I want to share with all of you, you know, India has a great potential to submit all their projects, but I've always seen this mindset with a lot of us, that we feel that in order to participate on the global platform, on the maybe on the CEDIA or anywhere, you know, it can be any platform, I'm not just talking about CEDIA. We always feel that my project has to be something which is worth 100K plus, right? And that's what normally everyone's mindset is. But what I realized there, you know, that that's not the case. You know, you need not have a project which is worth $150,000 plus. You can even have a project which is as simple as a $20,000 or $25,000, $30,000 project. As long as, you know, you've done the things right and you feel it is worthy of an entry, please do put an entry. Because what happens is when these entries go in, based on the entries received, you know, let's say I'm giving an example of a category, home cinema. So let's say the best home cinema for EMEA, right? So when you receive a lot of these entries are then seen vis-a-vis, of course, the cost of the project. And then they are categorized in different levels. So it is not necessary that your 25, 30, 40,000, I'm just using this number as an example, that a $40,000 project may not win an award for you. You know, it may be in that same category of that $40,000 or $50,000, which they call it as a level one, for example. The higher ones may be called as level two, level three, and so on, depending on the entries received. So my only submission to all of you is, please participate. You know, don't even bother whether you have an award-winning project or not. At least try and participate, because you never know, your first entry, as we have seen as a history with all our Indian winners, they participate for the very first time and they win an award. And I'm sure Manoj and Anand can also, you know, agree to it, because that's how I've seen the trends, you know. Last year participating for the first time, and they ended up winning a finalist to the best showroom category. So I at least remember that.
Yeah. To add on to what Rupesh said, if I talk about the last year's award, one of the Indian awards for EMEA and the global for home cinema was not a very costly solution which Indian partner has provided. And no, in spite of not reaching to the level one, the $40,000 category, it was way beyond 20,000, and still they could win the not only the EMEA award, but they could win the global award as well. So that's the classic example of last year. If we talk quote, if you see the CEDIA yearbook of 2019, you'll be able to know that how they won the award, not only on the basis of value, but the on the basis of the technicality, the design, and the overall documentation. So that's the classic example of that.
And just to give you a heads up, the last date for submission for this year is going to be April 20th. So we still have a lot of time. And I am more than happy to help you with whatever I can in terms of, you know, the documentation that you may want to understand. And though Manoj doesn't share this, but I want to share on his behalf that Manoj himself has volunteered to help any member who wants help in preparing the documentation, because that's one thing which we all fear, the documentation part. And I know otherwise, I am sure India has a potential to win a lot of awards. You know, all of you do fantastic work, and it's just time that we start coming up on the global platform. And anyone who is very keen, we can take this discussion offline, as we are running short of time. But I'll also explain to you how this will also help you showcase your business better to your client, to your customer, to your interior designer. So that's one more point to just check, you know, how will the CEDIA platform help you to gain more business? This is one of those. So over to Manoj again.
If I talk about the another tool which is available, the fantastic tool, I have used it quite a few times. I am using since last more than 2 years, the CEDIA Designer. It is a home cinema design tool, very quick, basic TCD tool. Is free for members. When you become a member, it is completely free. If you want to design a media room, it is completely free for all the members. And there are other 3 paid categories also, like Media Room Pro, which is available to the members only at $350 per year. And you can do 365 designs from that PCD practically every design a day. And believe me, when you prepare your prospects with TCD and you present it to client and the architect, chances are there that over the competition you have all the respects and you bring value to the table. And then we have another category called cinema room, which is only available for $425 USD. And the Cinema Room Pro, which is the ultimate, which I use, it is, if you take a single use, it is $145. If you use for a month, it is only available at $65. And if you are taking a year package, 365 design is available only for $500 USD, which is almost nothing. And it is a very good tool. If you design it manually, it may take a week to design the way the software provide the documentation and the design and the RT values and the processing, everything, including the video parameters, audio parameters. So just go through it. It is a wonderful tool. And my request to all the members, then please go through it. And whenever you find any problem, I have helped a lot to other Indian members. And if you have any queries, please get in touch with us so that we can help you with the, you know, it's a complete ready document for proposal and to present. Can you move to the next slide, please? One more initiative CEDIA has taken, and it is going to roll out in a grand way. This point is very close to my heart, and Rupesh, allow me to speak more on this. The CEDIA Outreach Instructor course is a wonderful free and member only benefit, and can benefit yourself and your business. The COI course is nothing but to get near to the design and build fraternity. We have around 9 to 10 modules which touch upon the various aspects of customized AV, be it home theater, be it media room, the connected home and all. So we have various modules to do the presentation with the design and fraternity. This is a special program designed by CEDIA, and it is running globally with all the the design associations like REBA in UK, and very soon the Rupeshan team is working very hard to have a nationwide rollout with IIID. And I think so, Rupesh, the IIID work has been, lot of work has been done in IIID for CUI, right?
Yeah, as we are talking about this, I have a call with the executive committee person who handles education there. We're going to have a call around 18th or 19th to finalize those things. So yeah, it's almost going to happen. And after that, we will have a lot of visibility with the IIID at least, because that also has a lot of chunk of the interior designers and architects. So at least there we'll start getting a lot of visibility created, and we are going to plan events around it.
So basically, I will touch upon the basic of CUI. CUI is nothing but the presentation of how CEDIA member helps design fraternity to do a better solution. And it's an opportunity to interact more with the design fraternity. And we have few COIs available here, and very soon we will have more COI will get trained, and we will have a zone wise COI, so that in your respective states and cities, you can interact more with the IIID and the design fraternity through this tool. And when you use this tool, I'll share one example. When I done my first CPD with one of the architect office, they were like, when I handed over the CEDIA certificate to them and their staff, they were felt like happy, and few of them have actually posted in the social media, and that way we could get some mind space in their entire office. So it's a wonderful tour. Anand, you can add on this something.
I would rather leave it to Manoj. I think he's got quite a bit any which way added on this aspect. I'm sure that the members will also find, I would say more. I don't know really how many are already members and how many more, but these are small nuggets of gold, I would say, for members to start using to engage more and to get ahead in their respective cities, with being the professionals and being taken seriously.
That's perfect. Can we move to the next slide, please? Recently, CEDIA has came up with the two new programs apart from the regular membership, advancement which some of the CEDIA members are continuously doing the education, and the they won the award and they have the certification. So CEDIA has came up with the two more category, which is a kind of we can say the premium category of members, to provide an edge over the overall membership. One is the CEDIA Advanced Member, when you and your team are having a continuous education and you provide the best customer service, and so then we have a program called CEDIA Advanced Member. All the relevant details are available on the website, and still if you need any help, you can be in touch with Rupesh or any of our volunteers. And then we have one more one level up program called CEDIA Member of Excellence. When you become a CEDIA Advanced Member, then you have to prepare for the CEDIA Member of Excellence. You need to achieve certain certification. You need to be at a finalist in the CEDIA Awards, or you need to win one of the awards, and then you can apply for the CEDIA Member of Excellence. And I wonder if Wendy can help us understanding this slide in a better way. Wendy?
Yes, certainly. It's a way of differentiating yourself and allowing people to better understand the focus in your own business, but also what your specialities are as well. So it is a way of recognizing people who make investment in education and their staff and building their business, and just allows people a better marketing tool as well to be able to get in front of both clients and design professionals.
Yeah. Thank you, Wendy, and thank you, Rupesh, for allowing us to discuss on few very important points. You can take this forward from here. Yeah, Rupesh.
Sure. So thanks to Manoj and thanks to Anand for contributing with their understanding on this slide. I would like to talk more about how do we, you know, support industry success, you know, and by doing that and by saying this, what we are talking about is we create many opportunities for individuals to stay connected with CEDIA and the community. And how do we do that is going to be talked through in the next few slides by Anand. So over to Anand, and you can take this through.
Thanks, Rupesh. As you guys can see that there is a CEDIA Expo 2020, God willing, and if everything is smooth, September is still quite some time away. And every year CEDIA Expo happens, placing the industry professionals at the center of, you know, the future home experience. CEDIA Expo 2019, that happened in Denver, Colorado, last year, and that was quite a success. Unfortunately, I couldn't make it, but it was a good show. Members took advantage of the special member pricing for the show floor and the training sessions that happened out there. There were technical and business trainings that were held prior to the show opening, and through to Saturday, there were about 125 CEDIA courses. 60 of those courses were completely new. I mean, adapting to what we need to be aware about and use it to our advantage. Of course, the CEDIA booth completely busy all the time with, some of the familiar faces, some of the newer faces. They have also created a format of a, you know, like a TED talk kind of small sessions, that kept going on during the day, offering crucial insights on emerging trends, newer technologies, and help us strengthen business practice. You can actually check out some of these on the CEDIA YouTube channel as well, giving you some insight on that. On the 8th of September, like I said, God willing, the show is back in Denver again. And if you guys can mark your calendar for that, you would be in for a treat. We can have the next slide on this. Yeah. Oh, ISE. ISE 2021 supposed to happen in Barcelona. It used to happen in Amsterdam for the last 10 years, I think. And for your knowledge, CEDIA co-owns ISE along with AVIXA. AVIXA, which was Infocom earlier, is now AVIXA. CEDIA co-owns the ISE show. And it's pretty much the largest show that I've seen in our industry, because ISE hosts both residential and commercial manufacturers, all showcase their latest tech concepts. I think in one of the most successful AV shows in the world. I think even 2020, although there was a fear for, there was a little bit of a the timing issue in terms of the COVID fear that emerged, but still I think there were over 55,000 visitors for that show, So I think it was quite successful. The kind of content, the kind of stuff that they showcase, the networking opportunities, training classes running throughout the week, you know, very, very useful and practical. And as a member, we have quite a bit of benefits. So, you know, definitely can take a good advantage of, you know, these events. I think Manoj would be able to give a little bit more of insight on this, you know, in the next slide.
Yeah. Thank you, Anand. When we go to ISC to attend the exhibition, it is not only the exhibition. A lot of education opportunities we have during the show, before the show, and after the show. We need to we can meet a lot of people because ISC show is a very important and very big show. People from across the globe coming to explore the new technology which is coming up in residential and commercial, both the markets, and in audio, video, automation, everything. And you happen to network with people, you need to know, you tend to understand the best practices, the challenges in respective areas. And I think so it's a great platform to grow in the industry. I always try and attend this show since last few years, and next year, since we having a bigger and better venue, it's all set. I would also request all the members to join us for the party. We have a lot of fun, the Indian members, especially the Indian members. We have a lot of good insight, the good meetings, after meetings, and we are having a great time at ISC show. Anand.
Yeah. So I think Rupesh, you can take this forward. You know that there is quite a bit that has already been covered.
Sure. So right. So just want to touch a little on the insights. What we mean by insights here is the CEDIA insights that you keep on getting from an industry perspective. There are various avenues or tools that you can actually get your insight from, so who does that? There's a CEDIA Tech Council who's actually the brain behind getting together. They are the brightest minds around the globe who get together at the Tech Council. They are normally the industry leaders, and they are keeping a track on what are the trends that are impacting your business, and based on that they come out with a lot of meaningful information throughout the year, either through the blogs, the CEDIA blogs, either through our CEDIA Communicates, that's a magazine, a quarterly magazine every quarter that we release, and you can subscribe to it. Its subscription is free even for non-members. Just to clarify, if anyone would want to get a copy of it, please let me know. Even if you're not a member, it doesn't really matter. The CEDIA podcast, yes, that's actually an upcoming way of being in touch with what's happening latest, because we are all an industry which is really robbed of our time, either because we are busy doing installations, projects, customer meetings, site meetings, a lot of those things. So the best way nowadays, which I'm seeing and which is catching up everywhere around the world, is you just, when you're driving, just get into a podcast, listen to a podcast, you can pause it, resume it later. So through the podcast, all this information is given out, So I would recommend highly that these podcasts are actually free. So it doesn't really matter whether you're a member or a non-member, you can still have an access to it. So all this is done. And lastly, of course, the think tank also produces white papers, and it delivers a critical direction to help develop CEDIA training content. So these are some of these, steps that we take to ensure the industry success. And with this, I think we're almost gonna come to an end, so I would like to move on to the next slide, and let's take a last bit of time to dive into some of the great questions that you've submitted. So Jen, can you let us know is there anything that is pending to be answered?
Hey, yeah, there was one question which I think would be which would be great to answer now. Let's pull this up. So someone has asked if there is a suggested roadmap for someone just starting in the industry. Obviously, there's quite a few established companies within the community. So how would you suggest someone starts out? Where's the best place and point that they could start? Is that through our training? Is that through our online stuff? Based on your experience, how would you suggest they start?
Sure, that's a very good question, and I would like to take Manoj and Anand's help. Not that I can't answer this, but I would like to have the industry talk about this, because I mean, they are doing it, and no one better than them to answer this question. So over to maybe, you know, Anand and Manoj to just give a little guideline on.
I would like to answer it from my perspective. I mean, we never started off big. I started off this business as a hobby. But when I started it off, I started realizing that you needed to be a little bit more professional, because there is a shortage of professionals in our industry. Even if there are bigger players, or it doesn't really matter. You got to start somewhere. So you might as well start at wherever you are, and you start focusing on improving your approach. Get to be a little bit more professional. You need to have the tools. You need to have the trainings. You need to understand, as Manoj mentioned, THX certification, maybe, other certification courses are there, but one step at a time. You need to do that. You can't do this overnight. It takes time. I can only assure this much, that, you know, we are all sitting at the point where home technology is not an option. It's a compulsion for every homeowner. So from their perspective, they definitely want to deal with a professional. If you don't update yourself and keep yourself aware of the latest trends, the latest technology, you're not going to be in a good place. So I don't see, from my perspective, I don't see it as a choice of not to, you know, keep updating myself. I need to be here. And I think, you know, you guys provide the perfect platform for it. So the value is there. Manoj, you can have your comments.
And I think so. Every individual will know, can have a different roadmap, because no, every individual have a some kind of strength and some kind of opportunities within the company they line. If they are good at automation, they can start from the basics of AV, and they can grow in the AV industry. If you are good at automation and AV both, then you can probably explore the basic of lighting part, and then you can grow over the lighting part. And it's purely the, I think so, that's my perspective, that everyone has a different roadmap to grow in the industry. And because we have somebody who is already into automation and want to come into AV, somebody is there in AV and want to come into lighting. So then roadmap and the trainings can be different for all the members. That's what I believe. Adding to the resources which we have, which we have not touched upon, one resources which is a very good resource, which is kind of basic residential electronic system book, which is available for CEDIA members at a nominal cost, and the advanced residential electronic system book, which is a very, very handy tool to refer for all kind of aspect of the audio visual and the control and everything, apart from the resources which is available, and especially the white paper I use a lot. White paper are the best tool to understand that particular domain of the subject. And CEDIA members, I would request that just go through the website. Lot of information, lot of resources are available. And whenever you feel issue with that, you can be in touch with, now we have a Rupesh on board. You can be in touch with them. And you can always touch in with the volunteers like us. And we have a lot many members near you, and you can take help from them. Over to you, Rupesh.
So thank you. Thanks to both of you for all the time that you've spent and also answered questions from your perspective. Because I feel that's more relevant. And to anyone who feels there are some questions you need to ask, always reach out to me. We can discuss more in details. Right now, since we have a time crunch, we cannot get into too much of details. But yes, there is a roadmap as to for anyone who starts, let it be a one member, a single man outfit company, as we call it, right up to scaling yourself up to a big organization. We have all the roadmap in place for any of you who wants to actually take use of this platform. So that is what I would submit. And towards the end, I would say make the most of your membership. And I would not talk about all these because all these have been discussed in details. But I would like to end up with a very relevant example. This is absolutely on a lighter note that I would like to speak about. You know, it's like a lot of times I face this question that, you know, I had. See, it happens, right, with all of us that an industry peer refers and tells that, you know, be a part of CEDIA. And yes, we do that. But what happens invariably over a period of time is, since we do not get too much time, we end up not really looking at what all can I gain out of this membership. I would not blame anyone here. It's our busy schedules. And that's the reason why I am trying to, you know, talk to a lot of you and give you a lot of insights on how to use this membership to your advantage, you know, to build yourself stronger in front of the customers, in front of the design and build community. But yes, towards the end, I would just say, do not underutilize this membership. You know, it's like you take up a subscription of a gym just to become thin. And at the end of 12 months, you do not go to the gym. And then you just ask a question, you know, what use is this membership to me? Of course, the answer to this is with you. It's equally up to all of us to help each other. I would request that anything that you feel you don't understand, you're not finding time, reach out. I'm there to help you. The members are there to help you. The volunteers are there to help you. But please make the most out of this membership by utilizing every possible resource that exists. And do keep on giving me a feedback. So I do not want a situation where, you know, we just talk about, you know, what was there in for me, when we need to put in that equal amount of effort from our side as well. So if there is a barrier in terms of time, let me know. I'm there available at any point in time for you guys. So with this, I would like to, you know, wrap up on our webinar for the day. And would of course like to again have Anand, would you like to share any final words of wisdom?
No, I don't think there's no compulsion. And I think it's all good in terms of what you said. It's like, you know, take a gym membership, you don't use it to the best extent. You know, it was there for the asking. So I'm sure that this particular webinar really added value, and giving members and potential members some insight as to the value that the membership brings. It's more value add for me in my business. I can only say, you know, recommend to everybody that you use the same value to, you know, for their own business development.
Thank you. That's about it. Thanks so much, Anand. And you, Manoj?
Thank you so much, Rupesh, for the wonderful webinar. And whenever I know my submission to all the members, that whenever you feel like that it is only paying the £350 to CEDIA, just go to website, try to find out. Every time, I assure you, every time you get a new resource, new inputs which will help you growing your business. And whenever you feel any issue, or you know, stuck up somewhere in terms of design or technology or somewhere else, the commercial part, get in touch with any of the CEDIA member across the globe. And I know I'm interacting with many members in other countries also. They are always ready to help you out. And I would urge all the members to make a most of it. And whenever you feel like any issue, just be in touch with Rupesh or any of the volunteers. Thank you so much, Rupesh.
Thank you, Manoj, for your feedback and your comments. And last but not least, I would just say that I'm very open for feedback, and that's what I've been doing. So do not even hold 1% of that thought that, how can I go and know. All critical feedback is welcome, because that's how, at least it helps me strategize my plans to add value to the industry. So that's the way that I work. And I think that's the way that it should be. It should be a very healthy feedback giving sessions across the industry so that we can improve, because at the end, it's all for the industry. It's nothing for anyone very specific. It's everything for the industry. So anything around the industry, I'm very much open for feedback, and more than happy to try and implement whatever I learn from your feedback. So yeah, I think that's all about it from our side. Maybe Wendy or Jen, would you like to add anything, or else we are good to wrap up?
I'd just like to say a huge thank you to Manoj and Anand for being there and sharing their experience. CEDIA is about a community, and volunteers such as that really show how that community can be valuable. But as they've outlined, it is down to you as an individual or as a company to take advantage of these tools available. And we are busy, we are very time poor. So again, that's where Rupesh can help you to better understand what are the important tools CEDIA has available for you and help you take advantage of them. And Rupesh, thank you for all your hard work.
And it's Jen here. Just want to echo on Wendy, say thank you. Without our members, we're nothing. So really do appreciate everyone for contributing, adding questions in throughout this webinar, having a great audience view. You've all been wonderful. You are supported by Rupesh, Wendy, myself, and a whole global membership team. So no matter the time zone, there is a member of staff that's here to support. Obviously, some of us are based in the UK, some of us are based in the US, and then with India, with Rupesh in India, there's always someone you can call upon. So please. Member@cedia.org is our email, and you can reach out to us at any time, and we'll always be happy to help and to guide you in the right way.
Absolutely. Thanks to everyone, and thanks to the industry. Thanks to all our members. Thanks to all the volunteers who are supporting me on the ground, and of course, the support staff at the back end. It's needless to say that without all of us together, we can't do anything. So thanks so much, and keep tuning on to what's happening here with CEDIA. I'll keep you posted with what's happening, and we can always take an offline discussion on anything specific. You all have my number, so you can reach out to me. Thank you so much.
Hi, thanks Rupesh.
Thank you Rupesh, Wendy, thanks, and Jen, and thanks Anand for joining.
Thank you. Bye.
Yeah, thanks to both of you for pulling. I had to pull you out of everything for this webinar. So thanks a lot for you.
They're always there to support you.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Bye.